In this video, we will see example regarding swing application. Now there is some code. There are two labels which are created. One is for name and other is for password. After that, I put some text field which will take the input. And there are two buttons. One is submit button and other is cancel button. So this is submit button and say this is cancel button. Now what I want, when I click on submit button, it will print some message, and when I click on cancel button, it will print some other message. So that is done. On to the next slide. First, I am adding all these components to some panel, and after that I am writing one method which is on to the third slide. The method name is action performed. This action performed method is the abstract method of action listener. Now in this method I am defining what to do on particular action. If user clicks on equals button or submits button, if caption equals submit, then I will print logged in successful. Otherwise I will print are you sure you want to exit. So let me implement this application and let's observe the output practically.
I have implemented here swing application, which is very simple and making use of basic swing components. There is one J label, username, password label is there, corresponding text fields are there, submit button is there, cancel button is there. So this will create UI which is something like this. Now after that I am adding these components to one panel. I am adding label, username, p label, password, submit button, cancel button, all the components to panel. So that is UI creation part. After that I need to handle events. For that I am writing one class which is perform action class, which is implementing the action listener. So when I click on button, it will be called to the action listener. In that I am overriding action perform method. In the action perform method, if submit button is pressed, then I will print message onto the console login successful, and if cancel button is pressed, then I will print message onto the console whether do you want to exist. This listener class, or rather this perform action class objects, are added by using add action listener method onto submit button and cancel button. So let me run the code. So this will give me UI. Suppose I print some name and password and I click on submit button. So when I click on submit, it is giving message logged in successful. And if I click on cancel button, it will give message are you sure you want to exit. So these events are handled by using action listener and implementing method or overriding method action performed. So this is how we implement any UI based application in Java.